And here is the Writer's Almanac for Wednesday, the 22nd of April, 2020. Today is Earth Day, a day first observed in 1970 at the prompting of Senator Gaylord Nelson of Wisconsin. About 20 million people participated in the first Earth Day, April 22, 1970, and soon after came the formation of the Environmental Protection Agency, the Clean Air Act, Clean Water Act, the Endangered Species Act. It became an international event in 1990, events in 141 countries. In 2000, Earth Day was coordinated on the Internet. According to the Earth Day Network, Earth Day is celebrated, observed in some form by a billion people every year. It's the birthday of the man who once wrote, "Love and scandal are the best sweeteners of tea." Henry Fielding, the novelist, born in Somerset, England, 1707. He started out writing for the stage. He was writing political satires, and there were many people in government who did not take kindly to that. And so, in 1737, Parliament passed the Theatrical Licensing Act, which required plays to be approved by the Lord Chamberlain. And Henry Fielding, knowing that none of his plays were likely to be approved, retired from the stage, became a novelist, and wrote The History of Tom Jones, a Foundling, the story of a lusty, good-hearted young man who falls in love with his neighbor's daughter. It's the birthday of the legendary jazz bassist and composer Charles Mingus, born in Nogales, Arizona, in 1922. And it's the birthday of the poet Louise Glück, born New York City, 1943. Her father, an immigrant from Hungary, helped to invent the X-Acto knife. She won the Pulitzer Prize for her collection The Wild Iris in 1992. Louise Glück, who said she tends to write poems that operate on a vertical axis of transcendence and grief, and who had a word of wisdom for young poets, she said, "It never gets easier to write." And it's the birthday of Paula Fox, born in New York City, 1923. Her parents, charming people, had no interest in being parents. Her mother, a beautiful socialite. Her father, a Hollywood screenwriter. They loved drinking, going to parties. And a few days after the girl was born, they abandoned her at an orphanage in Manhattan. She was passed off to various caregivers, married and divorced a second time, wrote stories. And then in the 60s, she published 15 books in 10 years, including Desperate Characters, which was rediscovered a few years ago by the novelist Jonathan Franzen, who fell in love with it, wrote an essay in Harper's, whereupon W.W. Norton reprinted Desperate Characters. Paula Fox also wrote a memoir of her childhood, Borrowed Finery. Here's a poem for today by Lucy Shaw, entitled Signs. In time of drought, let us be thankful for this very gentle rain, a gift not to be disdained, though it is little and brief, reaching no great depth, barely kissing the leaves' lips. Think of it as mercy. Other minor blessings may show up, tweezers for splinters, change for the parking meter, a green light at the intersection, a cool wind that lifts away summer's suffocating heat, an apology after a harsh comment, a word that opens an unfinished poem like a key in a lock. A poem by Lucy Shaw, Signs, from Eye of the Beholder, published by Paraclete Press and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.